Praise the Lord. We bless God. Let's turn our Bibles quickly to Ezra chapter 7 verse 10. Ezra 7 verse 10. For Ezra had prepared and set his heart to seek the law of the Lord, to inquire for it and of it, to require and yearn for it, and to do and teach in Israel its statutes and its ordinances. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus, we have read your word. Let your spirit capture your word and release them into our hearts. Let a fire of this word, let the illumination of the word, let the light of the word permeate every part of our being. And let the entrance of your word today give and bring light and understanding to the simple. We thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God. We just read God's word concerning the man of God, Ezra, a man that was a priest, very skillful priest. And Ezra had to join the Babylonian captives in some part of the duration or the years in their captivity. And the Bible says that this Ezra, this man Ezra, he came even to the captives as a man that was prepared, a man that was a ready and a skillful priest. The Bible said that he prepared his heart to seek the law of the Lord, to do it in his own life, and to teach it in Israel. And because of that, he gained so much favor before the king of Persia. And whatever he requested, the king gave to him. He was that powerful. He shows us what the word can do, how the word can give us power, how the word can give us favor, how the word can give us audience before great men and before great women. Because the word of God in our lives is just God in our lives in the word form. Hallelujah. Today, we are looking at searching the word. Searching the word. Searching the word. So search the word. The thing you need to do is to search the word. That's the ninth thing you can do with the word. The ninth thing you can do with the word. Search the word. We explore almost everything under the sun, but most people don't explore the word. The word search means to explore. So do an exploration. All things under the sun have their limits, but God's word, who is God, is exceedingly broad. And that's what David said in Psalm 119, verses 96, even to verses 100. David said, I have seen and observed that everything that is man-made, everything under the sun, everything that man has created has limits to it. But David came to a conclusion that the word of God has no limits. And therefore, verse 97 of Psalm 119, David decided he would dedicate himself to love the word so that he himself will become limitless. He will operate without boundaries of limitation. Hallelujah. The word of God is inexhaustible, so we can never exhaust our search. The word of God is exceedingly broad. The word is inexhaustible, so we can never exhaust our searching of the word. That's what makes it amazing. Every time you look into the word, you find new things that call for a search. Every time we approach the word, we find new things that opens up for us to search the word. What does it mean to search? The Hebrew word used here is darash. Darash. It means to tread or frequent. It means to tread or frequent. What it means is that it's to walk in a certain way or walk on a certain path and frequently be on that path. That is what it means to search. To take a walk or to take a place to tread and constantly keep flowing and frequenting the place. Usually it means to follow. A search means to follow. So to follow means a search. When you can follow the tracks of someone, You can follow the tracks of something. Search means to follow. Follow by pursuit or follow by search. By implication, it means to seek, to ask, and specifically to worship. So we search with a heart that will drive us into becoming men and women of worship. Men and women who walk with God in spirit and in truth. The question is, how do we search? There are six ways to search in this presentation. Six ways to search. Number one, we must search with assurance. Anybody who searches must search with assurance. If you search without assurance, then you don't need to search at all. In 2 Samuel 22, verses 31, 2 Samuel 22, 31, and cross-reference it with Psalm 18, verse 30. Psalm 18, verse 30. The Bible says that the word of the Lord is tried and tested. The reason why I give the scripture here is that I have been on exploration before, trying to help a certain company to come into this nation in order to explore gold. So I need to go ahead and go and make sure we prepare the grounds for them. Go scout the places where gold can be found. We went to the commission in charge of making sure they look into the map and tell us where gold can be found. We did all that. Then we got people who had a mind or understanding of doing what we call soil testing for the gold. And all these things they did is to make sure they paved the way so that we can search with assurance. When they tested some of the samples of the soils they were able to extract, some had gold, but not in commercial quantities. And some do have gold in commercial quantities. And those places became our focus, because those were the things the company were looking for. They were looking for places where they can extract gold in commercial quantities. This many, many years ago. I don't do that anymore now. But many, many years ago, I used to even go and lead people into these things to help them and not be swindled and not be robbed by wrong people. Hallelujah. So search with assurance. Once we follow what the samples tells us, then we can actually search with assurance. But God's word says the word of the Lord is tested and tried. So searching the word, we must search with assurance, because we know what we are searching has been tried and has been tested over the years before creation and during creation. We need to understand that. Number two, if we are searching, we must search with a conviction. We must search with a conviction. The Bible says in Ezra 7:10 that we read, that a man Ezra prepared his heart. In other words, he came with a conviction. Some of us will search the word, will read and study the word, but we don't search with conviction. The things we find do not define our conviction. But whatever we search, or whenever we are searching, we must go searching with conviction. I know why I'm searching. I know what I want. I know what I want to receive. I know what I want to get. We should go into the search with that conviction. And then things will work well for us. Number three, we must search by the Spirit. We must search by the Spirit. The Bible tells us in the book of Corinthians that the Spirit of the Lord is the one who searches the deep things of God. In John 6:63, in John 6, verse 63, Jesus said, "The words that I speak, they are spirit, and they produce life." So if the word of the Lord is spirit, then we need the same spirit to help us to search the spirit. Because Jesus said, "My word, they are spirit, and they produce life." So for you to search the word that is the spirit, it is wise, it is logical, it is proper, it is spiritual to ask the Spirit of God to help us to search the spirit of the word. Hallelujah. In Zechariah 4:6, the Bible said this, our search is not by might, nor by power, but by the Spirit of the Lord. And Ephesians chapter 6, verse 17, Ephesians 6:17, the Bible makes it clear that the word of the Lord is the sword of the Spirit. The word of God is the sword of the Spirit. So we need the Spirit in order to search. And finally, Isaiah 59 verse 21, under set by the Spirit, the Bible says God gave Israel a covenant of the Spirit and a covenant of the Word. So the Spirit and the Word of God goes together and walk hand in hand. If you want to search, you must search by the Spirit. Number four, search with your heart. Search with your heart. Psalm 77 verse 6. Ecclesiastes chapter 1 verse 3. Ecclesiastes 1 verse 3. And Ecclesiastes 7:25. The Bible made it clear that when we are searching, we should search with our hearts. And once we search with our heart, we shall find. Our heart must be into what we search. Our heart must go into what we search. We must invest our heart into searching the word. So that Isaiah chapter 1 will not be our case, where God said, these people, they seek me. They try to know me, but they say things with their lips, but their hearts are far away. So it's possible to search God's word with a heart that is distant from our search. May we never be found searching with our heart distant from the search. Finally, number six, search with the appropriate tools. Search with appropriate tools. Search with the appropriate tools. Search with the appropriate tools. Let me go over before I draw my conclusion. I said for us to search, you must search with assurance. Number two, search with conviction. Number three, search by the Spirit. Number four, search with your heart. Number five, search with an expectation. Jeremiah 29 verse 13, search with an expectation. Jeremiah 29 verse 13, Ezra chapter 4 verse 19, Matthew chapter 2 verse 8, then Matthew 7 verse 7. I go over. Jeremiah 29 verse 13, Ezra 4 verse 19, Matthew chapter 2 verse 8, and Matthew chapter 7 verse 7. We must search with an expectation. And number six, we must search with the appropriate tools. We must search with the appropriate tools. John chapter 5 verse 39. We must search with appropriate tools. In conclusion, anything you classified as a treasure will become your automatic search. Anything you classified as your treasure will become your automatic search. It's my prayer that the word of the Lord will become our treasure so that we can easily search for it. Jesus said, the kingdom of God is likened to a woman who saw pearls hidden in a field. She go gather money and come and buy the field in order to get the treasure. And the Bible says, where our heart is, our treasure will be. And where our treasure is, our heart search will take place. May the Lord help us to search his word. And search his word with all we got. Search his word with all our passion. And search his word with our heart. Remember, Jesus said, ask and you shall receive. And then you should seek or search and you shall find. Knock the door and the door will fling open. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus, we pray, O God, that you will help us, O God, even to treasure your word in order to drive our search of you and your word. And as we search, O God, bring us into the depths of your word. Bring us into the depths of your truth. And may we be transformed for good. We bless you. We glorify you in Jesus' name. Again, this is Shamosin Gloriabe, your pastor and a loved one, bringing you God's word on this mega breath devotional. This mega breath devotional. I know that you have received God's word that will change and transform your life for good. I come again your way next time around with another word as to what to do with the word of God. God bless you, and I love you. Mega Shalom. Amen.